You know, recent trend photo quality getting better and better, even the DSLR and even the smartphone. My friends ask me about why your photo is so good and tell me about how you take a photo, but I really do not understand it because, you know, you grab a camera and just you take the photo, but that was totally a mistake. So today, I want to talk about how I take the photo. So, okay, without further ado, let's get into it. So, okay, let me talk with the gears at first. I usually grab the camera with the full body, two or three lenses, of course, and tripod and the flashlight. You know, we sometimes do forget charging the battery or missing some items. And when I get to the place where I wanna take a photo, I notice like, oh my gosh, my battery is about to die or I'm missing something. So I pay most attention to the things that I carry on. Before I jump into how I take a photo, there are significant settings for me. I actually take a photo. So let me talk about that first. The one is make sure you're using the focus. There are two types of the focus in the camera, autofocus and the manual focus, and that is totally up to you guys which focus you're gonna choose, but I personally choose the manual focus because I want to control everything on the photo, even the aperture, like where is focus, where has the bokeh, or what is the number of the aperture. Controlling the focus is really important for me, but I also use the autofocus when I want to set the like roughly focus. Camera tells us the exact and the best number of the focus and every style. So sometimes I set the autofocus, but you know, it is definitely case by case which focus you're gonna choose. But if you want to improve your photo skills, I recommend you guys to set the manual focus. And also, when you get to the place where you wanna take a photo, first things you're gonna do is understand how the lights goes. Light setting is so important, even for the videos, photos, and all the stuff. And light settings is not only for the like, you know, shadows and the brightness, but also contrast and all stuffs you need for the better photo. And there are three light styles that I show you on the previous video, so if you didn't check that out, I highly recommend you guys to check it. There's some links somewhere right here. So anyway, light setting is so important. You shouldn't take a photo when you get to the place sooner. You have to understand the lighting is so important. Then eventually you can take a photo. Grab your camera and think about angles, views, and all the stuff. It doesn't really matter if you take a photo with the auto style or manual mode, but I prefer taking a photo with the auto in the first time. Since, like I said, camera tells us that everything, like exact number of the settings, ISO, shutter speed, and aperture, I prefer taking with the auto mode in the first times, and that is so easier. But I never use the auto mode when I'm taking a photo in the dark or night or something like that, because when I try to take a photo in the dark, that is too exposed and so bright and noisy, and then I don't even know what I'm doing, that is too bright, that is not something that I wanted. So I always set the manual mode when I take a photo in the dark from the first time. But I never use the auto mode from the second time because, you know, you might get some critique from the first time, like, oh my gosh, this photo is too bright, shutter speed is different, focus is vague, and you can fix your problem from the second time. If your photo is bright, you can either increase your aperture or decrease your shutter speed. I personally control the shutter speed in the first place, and next I control the focus and adjust a little bit. One tip that I can say to you is take a photo as many as you can because you really do not understand what is the good photo or bad photo in the small digital screen or, you know, small digital iPhone. So you really have to try and edit with the different style and the different settings, like changing the ISO, shutter speed, and the aperture, or focus the like, you know, some other things, or try with the different angles. You know, you really have to try and edit, and there's no shortcut for the better photo, and that is, you know, long way to get the better photo, but I think that is really fun and exciting if you are the like real photographer. So thank you for watching this video. How do you like it? If you have your own way of taking a photo, please tell me and give me the comment below. And if you like this video, you know what you're gonna do. Please subscribe and smash the thumbs up and stay tuned because I'm gonna see you guys in the next videos. So goodbye.